This video shows you how to align the table to the blade for your SawStop industrial cabinet saw. For accurate cuts, the blade and miter slots should be parallel, within a certain tolerance. In addition to cross cuts that you make with the miter gauge, alignment is also important for rip cuts, since the fence is aligned to the miter slot, which in turn references the blade. The tolerance limit is 10/1000ths of an inch. This is the difference in runout between a tooth as measured at the front of the blade and that same tooth as measured when at the rear of the blade. If your SawStop industrial cabinet saw is under that tolerance, that's great. There is nothing to be gained by working through the adjustment process. Further, if you are happy with the precision of your cuts for the particular work you are doing, again, there is no value in adjusting the table alignment. If outside that tolerance, or you are not satisfied with the precision of the cuts, this video shows you two methods to align the table. The first method uses a combination square and feeler gauges. The second method uses a dial gauge. The video shows the combination square method first, and then summarizes the dial gauge method. To begin, turn off the saw and remove the lockout key. And turn off and lock the disconnect switch. Remove the insert and blade guard, or riving knife. Set the blade to maximum elevation. Set the tilt to zero. When you reach the tilt limit stop, back the hand wheel off just slightly. If the mechanism is tight against the limit stop, it could cause the trunnion to twist slightly, possibly giving a misleading measurement for the alignment. Install a new and clean blade. Do not use a painted blade. Make sure the miter slot is free of debris. Mark one of the teeth. Loosen the locking knob on the combination square and adjust the blade, or ruler, so that you begin with the end of the ruler well away from the tooth. I'll refer to the blade of the combination square as ruler to avoid confusion with the saw blade. Place the combination square in the miter slot. Rotate the blade until the marked tooth aligns with the end of the ruler. Hold the anvil firmly against the side of the miter slot, and then slide the ruler so that it lightly touches the side of the marked tooth. Use a light touch here so you don't deflect the blade. Tighten the locking knob. After all that, make sure the end of the ruler is still resting lightly against the side of the tooth. Next, move the combination square to the back edge of the blade and rotate the blade so the marked tooth aligns with the end of the ruler once again. Visually check for a gap between the tooth and the end of the ruler, again holding the square firmly. If there is a gap, this means the table is rotated clockwise with respect to the blade when looking down on the table. The rotation in this illustration is exaggerated for clarity. Measure the gap with the feeler gauges. If more than 10/1000ths of an inch, the adjustment steps follow shortly. If 10/1000ths of an inch or less, you're good to go, and no further work is required. If the end of the ruler bumps into the front of the tooth, this means the table is rotated out of alignment counterclockwise. In this particular example, the table is rotated out of alignment clockwise, with a gap when the reference tooth is at the back of the blade. In this case, you'd use the adjusting screw on the left side of the table to pivot the table counterclockwise back into alignment. Left here means when looking from the front of the saw. The adjusting screws are threaded in the table and push against the rear trunnion. The table pivots on a pin pressed into the front trunnion. First, use a 17mm wrench to loosen the four cap screws that attach the table to the trunnions. Next, you'll loosen the adjustment screw on the right before you tighten the one on the left. Use a 5mm ball-end hex key to loosen the screw. With this step, you're just creating enough clearance between this screw and the trunnion to allow the table to pivot in the other direction. Now tighten the adjusting screw on the left side. Keep in mind the screw you are tightening has no effect until it contacts the trunnion. Take up the slat gradually, and you'll feel the screw contact the trunnion. After the screw contacts the trunnion, you should only need a small amount of rotation. To give a general idea of how much to turn the screw, a full turn yields approximately 35 thousandths of an inch deflection of the table. In other words, if the gap were 20 thousandths, you would tighten the screw approximately just one-third of a turn to bring the tolerance under 10 thousandths. Two-thirds of a turn would bring it close to zero. If you turn the screw too much, no big deal. Just loosen that screw and then tighten the screw on the opposite side to draw the table in that direction. You might need a few tries to get the table into tolerance. The key is small rotations of the hex wrench. If you look closely, you can also visually observe the gap closing as you slowly turn the wrench. If the table was out of alignment counterclockwise, that is, the ruler bumped into the face or front of the tooth, loosen the adjustment screw on the left, and then tighten the screw on the right to draw the table in that direction. Once you're satisfied with the alignment, tighten the four mounting cap screws. Finally, confirm the alignment is still within tolerance after tightening the cap screws. If you use a dial gauge rather than a combination square, note the following guidelines or factors. Understand how the dial gauge works, in particular, the values on the dials. You measure against the body of the blade. The measurement extents will be approximately 1/2 inch from the outer radius of the blade. It's important to hold the jig for the dial gauge firmly against the side of the miter slot as you set the gauge to zero and as you slide the probe across the blade body. As you slide the jig, the value on the dial will increase or decrease depending on the direction of misalignment and the direction you are sliding the jig. The total change between the front of the blade and the rear of the blade is the misalignment amount, essentially the same effect as if you measured the gap with a feeler gauge. By the way, the jig shown here was custom made by our engineers, but you should be able to find a suitable gauge and jig kit at your SawStop dealer or most any woodworking store. Install the blade guard or riving knife. Be sure to close the dust shroud door. Install the insert. Unlock and turn on the disconnect switch. Install the lockout key. You have learned how to align the table to the blade for your SawStop industrial cabinet saw. Thanks for watching. If you have questions, contact SawStop Service.